Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. In recent weeks, locust swarms have attacked crops in more than a dozen countries in Asia and also in Africa. The United Nations says the situation is extremely alarming in three regions: the Horn of Africa, the Red Sea area, and Southwest Asia. The Horn of Africa is the worst affected area. Locust swarms from Ethiopia and Somalia have reached south of Kenya and 14 other countries in the continent. In the Red Sea area, locusts have struck Saudi Arabia, Oman, and also Yemen. In Southwest Asia, locust swarms have damaged in Iran, Pakistan, and also in India. Huge swarms of locusts have struck border villages in states of Rajasthan, Gujarat, and Punjab, causing heavy damage to standing crop, prompting state governments to sound high alert against locust attacks. On this edition of In Depth, we'll talk about the current outbreak, countries affected by the crisis, and the steps being taken to control these destructive swarms of locusts. Besides, we'll also tell you what is this locust that is inflicting so much of damage. Neighboring Pakistan has declared a national emergency to tackle swarms of locusts that are destroying crops on a large scale. A locust emergency has also been declared in Somalia, where the outbreak is the worst in 25 years. The Food and Agriculture Organization warns that without international help, locust numbers could grow 500 times by June this year. More details on the current outbreak in this report. In the past few weeks, major locust attacks have been witnessed in several countries in Western and South Asia and also in East Africa. Faced with the worst such crisis in decades, Pakistan and Somalia have declared locust emergencies. In Pakistan, Prime Minister Imran Khan directed necessary measures to be taken on an emergency basis in view of the destruction caused by locusts to the crops. He ordered formation of a high-level committee to take decisions at the federal level to eliminate the insects. The Pakistani government has approved a national action plan of $7.3 billion to overcome the crisis.
The current situation in Pakistan is the locusts go on to keep on generating, and when they go on to breed, they grow on to breed in such a large number, like 20 becomes 400. 400 becomes 16,000, and Pakistanis have not been able to control it, or they are not willing to control the breeding of the locust. And the best way to prevent locust is the moment they're going to breed, that is the time when they're going to spread out so that they're going to kill en masse. This is what Pakistan is not doing it right now.
Desert locusts are large herbivores and resemble grasshoppers. They arrived in Pakistan from Iran in June and have already ravaged cotton, wheat, maize, and several other crops. The worst ever locust attack has been in the Punjab province, which is the country's main region for agricultural production. Standing crops and trees worth millions of rupees have been damaged in the Punjab province alone. Farmers from Sindh and parts of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa have also reported significant crop losses caused by the outbreak. Somalia too has declared the infestation as a national emergency and a major threat to the country's fragile food security situation. According to the Food and Agriculture Organization, locusts have caused one of the worst situations in 25 years in the Horn of Africa. Food sources for people and their livestock are at risk in this region. Locust attacks usually take place in June and July, as they are active only during the summer and rainy seasons. The current outbreak is being blamed in part on climate change. Experts warn that if lower temperatures continue and the weather remains wet for a longer time, it will spread even further. Experts say that the affected countries urgently require planes, ground vehicles, sprayers, pesticides, and personnel.
Are essentially short-horn grasshoppers. They go on to attack any place in form of swarms. Swarms means going to be in huge numbers. Now this number goes on to be of a substantial amount, and that can go on to cover something like some 7 to 8 kilometers of an area. They travel at a speed of 150 kilometers per hour of sorts, and they can go on to cross boundaries. Now these locusts, they go on to feed on and they sever on certain things like flowers, like leaves, like grasses, and they can go on to eat away anything. Any such type of attack is capable of completely denuding the land of its tree cover, of its grass cover or crop cover for maybe an area of about some hundreds of acres and thousands of hectares as well, depending on the size of it. Now, this is what exactly goes into constitute what we call is that locust attack.
Controlling locust swarms is no easy task. Larger the swarms, the more difficult it is to control them. Currently, the most commonly used control is insecticide. Sprayed from land or aerial vehicles, whole swarms can be targeted in relatively short periods of time. However, this has led to some environmental concerns. According to the United Nations, the timing of pesticide spraying is important to stop the locusts from damaging crops, plants, and also vegetation. Natural predators like wasps, birds, and reptiles may also prove effective at keeping small swarms at bay. However, for managing more established swarms, newly developed targeted microbial biopesticides offer a large-scale solution. However, one of the most effective ways to avoid the devastating effects of locust plagues is to prevent them from happening in the first place. Under a worst-case scenario where the current locust upsurge is not quickly contained and becomes a plague by the next cropping season of March to July, significant crop and pasture losses would cause food insecurity in affected areas to worsen. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV. Locusts belong to the family of grasshoppers, but they are different from grasshoppers in that they can migrate over large distances besides changing their behavior and habits. So what is the desert locust? Where does it breed and how does it manage to cause so much of damage? Let's find out in this report. Locusts are the oldest migratory pest in the world. They are different from ordinary grasshoppers in that they can change their behavior. They also form swarms that can migrate over large distances. Desert locusts are the most devastating of all locust species. During plagues, they affect 20% of Earth's land. That is more than 65 of the world's poorest countries and can damage the livelihood of 1/10 of the world's population. During quiet periods, desert locusts live in an area of about 16 million square kilometers between West Africa and India. Three pests, the Italian locust, the Moroccan locust, and the Asian migratory locust, jeopardize food security and livelihood in Caucasus and Central Asia, as well as in adjacent areas of northern Afghanistan and southern Russian Federation.
The first has been a prolonged monsoon in India. Essentially, in Rajasthan, it went on to begin from mid-July, which was at least 1 month before, and it went on to extend itself for more than 1.5 months also. Now, this goes on to give enough amount of a time for the locusts to breed themselves. That's reason number one. The second is, while the locusts go on to breed, and most of this breeding goes on to take place in some places like that of Pakistan nearby. So, during the time of breeding, only they are to be destroyed. If you don't go to destroy it at that point of a time, then it goes on to become very, very difficult for the locusts to be controlled. The third is the moisture conditions prevailing in that region and the wind conditions. Moisture conditions are actually very favorable for breeding of the locust. And because of this moisture condition, the locusts going to increase by numbers that you can't imagine, 20 to 400, 400 to 16,000 and so on. The last of this factor is the wind pattern. The wind pattern in over this whole of this region has been changing. And because it has changed, most of these locusts have gone on to find their way into India.
Locusts multiply, form groups, migrate over relatively large distances. If good rains fall and ecological conditions become favorable, they rapidly reproduce and increase 20-fold in just 3 months. In India, locusts breed in summer, while in Pakistan, they breed both in spring and summer. A desert locust adult can consume roughly about 2 grams every day. A swarm of 1 square kilometer size contains about 40 million locusts that can eat food consumed by 35,000 people, 20 camels or 6 elephants. A swarm the size of Paris eats the same amount of food in one day as half the population of France. Desert locusts breed in moist, sandy or sand clay soil to depths of 10 to 15 centimeters below the surface. They also need green vegetation for hopper development. However, the presence of moist soil and green vegetation does not automatically produce locusts. When desert locusts increase in number and become more crowded, they change their behavior from individual insects to acting as a group. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV. Time for a short break here on the program, but when we return, we'll talk about the states affected by locust attacks in India. Do stay with us. Welcome back. You're watching InDepth. India is also facing one of the worst locust attacks in decades. Rajasthan, Punjab and also Gujarat are the most affected states. In Rajasthan, Kharif and Rabi crops in 3.6 lakh hectares have been severely affected so far. Farmers in all these three states, already hard hit by the drought, are now the worst hit by the locust menace.
Not only Pakistan, India is also facing a severe locust attack. Locust attacks emanating from the desert area in Pakistan have struck parts of Rajasthan, Punjab and Gujarat, causing heavy damage to standing crop. Swarms of locusts measuring 3 kilometers in width and 1 kilometer in length entered Punjab through Fazilka district in January, triggering a high alert. Popularly known as Tidda, they were also spotted in some villages of Muktsar and Bhatinda districts. Officials said timely action against the attack helped in their elimination, adding that no damage was caused to crops. State authorities said as soon as swarms of locusts were spotted near the villages, about 400 to 500 tons of insecticides were used to eliminate pests. Boomer and tractor-mounted high-velocity sprayers besides fire brigade vehicles were used to control the pests. Punjab Chief Minister Captain Amrinder Singh has also written to Prime Minister Modi to press upon Islamabad to control the breeding of locusts in Pakistan. The CM had warned that any failure to control the pests could lead to serious implications for agriculture production in India, especially in Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan and Gujarat.
In India, it is going to be Rajasthan to begin with. It then went on to become Gujarat, Kutch and the adjoining regions of it. And now it has been Punjab. All of those states which go on to be adjoining to Rajasthan, and all of these states which go on to be having a high moisture content, because that goes on to allow good amount of breeding of the locusts.
Meanwhile, the swarms of locusts from Pakistan that invaded farms in parts of Gujarat and Rajasthan since December has resulted in an estimated loss of 5 crore rupees so far. Reportedly, around 3.5 lakh hectares of farmland in Gujarat and Rajasthan have been under locust attack. Crops of mustard, cumin and wheat have been devastated in the two states, affecting lakhs of farmers. In Gujarat, locust attacks in December damaged crops, mainly cumin seed, planted on about 17,000 hectares. In Rajasthan, the worst hit districts are Jaisalmer, Barmer, Jodhpur, Hanumangarh, Ganganagar, Bikaner and Sirohi. Rajasthan Revenue Minister Harish Chaudhary also wrote to Prime Minister Modi to declare emergency in 12 locust-affected districts, looking at the losses. Recently, the Rajasthan state government announced compensation worth 31 crore rupees for 4 affected districts after conducting a special assessment of losses. India deploys teams to control locust swarms that spray a chemical called organophosphate in small concentrated doses. India established a permanent locust warning and control organization under Indian Council of Agricultural Research in 1939. The LWO monitors locust scenario over desert areas in parts of Rajasthan and Gujarat. Its field headquarters is in Jodhpur. This apart, there is one field station investigation on locusts situated in Bikaner. According to authorities, India is prepared with sufficient trained manpower, vehicles, PP equipments, pesticides activated e-locust 3 units for locust surveys, population monitoring and control operation. However, the incursion of immature swarms or adults across the border is still continuing. Officials say control operation will be undertaken until invasion is stopped. It is said that the wind blowing from north to south is the reason that locusts are coming from Pakistan into India. India has not witnessed any full-blown locust cycles after 1962. However, during 1978 and 1993, large-scale upsurges were observed. Localized locust breeding was controlled in 1998, 2002, 2005, 2007 and 2010. Since 2010, the situation remained calm and no major breeding and swarm formation was reported. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Literature shows how locusts have triggered pervasive plagues over the course of history. The insects arrive unexpectedly, often after a change of wind direction or weather, and the consequences are devastating. Our next report details locust attacks in recent times in different parts of the world.
The Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations has currently identified 3 hotspots of locust activity where the situation is extremely alarming: the Horn of Africa, the Red Sea area, and Southwest Asia. The Horn of Africa is the worst affected area, where the FAO sees unprecedented threat to food security and livelihoods. Locust swarms from Ethiopia and Somalia have reached south to Kenya and 14 other countries in the continent. Ethiopia's Rift Valley has also been hit by the pest. The outbreak is the worst to strike Ethiopia and Somalia in 25 years and the worst infestation in Kenya in the past 70 years. Ethiopia and Somalia have not had an infestation like this in a quarter century. Destroying farmland and threatening an already vulnerable region with devastating hunger. Without international help, the FAO has said, locust numbers across the region could grow 500 times by June. While in the Red Sea area, locusts have struck in Saudi Arabia, Oman and Yemen. The swarms are presumed to have arrived from the Indo-Pakistan border area. And in Southwest Asia, locust swarms have caused damage in Iran, India and Pakistan.
That is a certain type of attacks. There are 3 areas which are where the locusts are very preponderant. First is Southwest Asia, so it can go on to be Iran, Iraq, Pakistan, Afghanistan. Second is the Horn of Africa, that goes on to include Ethiopia, Somalia. The third is region is going to be all the region and all the areas around Red Sea. That is going to be some portions of Arabian Peninsula as well as African Peninsula. Now, other than that, locusts have a history of attacking some places off and on in United States, also in Australia as well. But these are the main areas where the locusts are going to be attacking. And in India, it goes on to be the driest states of Rajasthan, Gujarat and Punjab.
The locusts first sighted in Somalia in December 2019 have since spread to Kenya and Ethiopia and are now within 200 kilometers of Uganda and South Sudan. According to the UN's Food and Agriculture Organization, the swarms of desert locusts that have spread across East Africa could soon threaten widespread food production as they continue to move to more areas. The hungry swarms threaten to aggravate food insecurity in a region where up to 25 million people are reeling from 3 years of droughts and floods in a row. Authorities are responding with aerial spraying of pesticides, but experts say the scale of the infestation is beyond local capacity, as desert locusts can travel up to 150 kilometers in a day and multiply at terrifying speeds.
We are in a region where over 11 million people in the three countries are already in acute food insecurity. Therefore, we need to make all possible effort to avoid such a deterioration. We know that these locusts, the locusts that we see here, can create really massive devastation, not only in terms of crop, but also in terms of pasture, and therefore affecting the livelihoods of the pastoralist communities. For that to happen at this critical point, the only solution that works is aerial spraying.
In the last two millennia, locust plagues continued to appear at irregular intervals, with the main recorded outbreaks of the desert and migratory locusts occurring in Africa, the Middle East and Europe. Other species of locusts caused havoc in North and South America, Asia and Australia. 173 outbreaks over a period of 1924 years have been recorded in China. The Bombay locust was a major pest in India and Southeastern Asia in the 18th and 19th centuries, but has seldom swarmed since the last plague in 1908. In the spring of 1747, locusts arrived outside Damascus, Syria, eating crops and vegetation of the surrounding countryside. In the 19th century, the extinction of the Rocky Mountain locust has been a puzzle. It had swarmed throughout the west of the United States and parts of Canada. Albert's swarm of 1875 was estimated to cover 5,10,000 square kilometers and weighed 27.5 million tons with some 12.5 trillion insects. The last specimen was seen in Canada in 1902. Looking at the current situation, the United Nations is appealing for urgent international action as the worst swarms of desert locusts in decades threaten to destroy farming regions across East Africa. With inputs from Vipul Agrawal, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's it from us on this edition of In Depth. We'll be back same time tomorrow now with a focus on some other subject of current significance. In case you missed the television broadcast, let me remind you, you can also watch our program online on YouTube and Twitter. And you can also share your feedback and suggestions about our program. Thank you for your time.